scene on the streets of Philadelphia. Swan Fountain in front of City Hall, two of the many landmarks in this great city. It's always been a great sports town, too. Normally this time of year, they're talking Flyers and Sixers, but this week, the brand new Core State Center plays host to the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. And more than U.S. titles are on the line, this is where they will name the American Olympic team. Two spots up for grabs for the men's pairs and ice dancing competitions, and three for the ladies. Hello and welcome, everyone. I'm Terry Gannon. We begin tonight with the men's short program. It kicks off what will be more than 13 hours of coverage here on ESPN2, over on ESPN, and on ABC Sports, including live coverage of the men's free skate, along with the ladies' short program. That's where you can see Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski going head-to-head Thursday night, beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern time on ABC. Well, there's no question that the overwhelming favorite here in the men's event is the 1996 world champion Todd Eldridge, but it hasn't been a great season for him, not one he had hoped for. In warm-ups for the first major competition of the season 2 months ago, this fall on the ice resulted in a separated shoulder. It popped back in, but it was an injury that really affected his skating throughout the season. Todd says now, though, he's ready to go, 100% healthy, ready to go after his fifth national title. Well, the two men joining me right now have not only won this title many times, but also the only gold medal that has eluded Eldridge, Olympic gold, Ryan Boitano and Mr. Dick Button. Take a look at Todd Eldridge this season, the season that he has had. What do you think his mindset is now coming into Philadelphia?
Well, look, anytime you consider Todd, you really got to consider his overall character as well as his personality. Remember, he has been through everything. He has won, he has lost, he's been healthy, he's been injured. There's nothing that can happen tonight that should faze him. One of the things you've got to remember is that he's the hardest worker of any skater here. He's also the steadiest competitor. You know, he can go up in the air into a triple axel on an angle and cat-like, right himself up and land on a steady edge. And I think maybe that word steady is the best adjective to use in describing him. Remember one thing. I hope and I'm sure that he will do very well right here.
Well, he's the favorite. There's no question about that. But you also have a guy named Scott Davis and Michael Weiss right behind him. Brian, they'd love to take his title away. How do you size up what those three will do tonight?
Well, Terry, I think it's really cut and dry. The key to tonight's short program is really the critical triple combination jump. Scott Davis, Todd Eldridge, and Michael Weiss are all planning the same combination, triple axel, triple toe. Now, this is high risk. And if any of them hopes to be a champion, they need to hit that combination.
The triple jumps all with a few scary attempts to challenge Todd Eldridge and to make the Olympic team. Michael Weiss, 21 years old, the silver medalist a year ago. There's his dad, Greg, on the right, his sister, Jenna, athletes themselves. Over the summer, he married his choreographer. There's Lisa, cheering him on, close to the surface of the ice.
Nice-looking family. And watch how he keeps the character of this dance throughout the entire program. That's unusual and very interesting. The music, Flamenco, by guitar soloist Jesse Cook.
And I really feel artistically Michael's made a lot of improvements over the last year, and you can see it in his programs that he's trying to reach in different directions.
This week from an outside edge. Beautiful jump.
Probably the easiest jump that Michael does. It's so easy for him.
That's why it's the lutz that he does as a triple, as a quadruple jump.
He'll try that quad lutz in the free skate. He says he's planning it. That'll be Thursday night on ABC.
Now on this coming up triple axel, note the fact that he does not step up.
To that one.
Wow.
A little far forward on the triple axel, but he still pulled off the triple toe afterwards.
I think the basic problem was that he doesn't step up into that triple axel and therefore doesn't get quite enough height. A little trouble on that back spin. Thank you. one of the required elements, a circular step. Painting the character from the dance. Now again, watch this. Forward edge jump. Nice double axel, but again, not very much step up into that. Good height on it, good height. And a good back sit spin.
Well, he's got to be happy with that.
I think so. Nice.
Oh, my! Yes!
Well, his dad's happy about it, that's for sure.
Kidding.
And they're not the only ones out of their seats here at the Core State Center. So the audience certainly liking the short program of Michael Weiss.
It was very, very good overall program.
We'll check his scores, no doubt high scores when we come back. And also Todd Eldridge will take the ice next. Michael Weiss along with Audrey Weisiger awaiting his scores after his short program.
The judges for required elements.
Look at the way he steps up into that triple axel. Hardly stepping up at all. That causes difficulty in getting height and distance and results in this little trouble that he had at the end of that jump combination.
And very little trouble. So much has been made of his quad lutz that he'll try in the men's free skate. He's just trying to hang on here in the short program. Nearly perfect, not quite. The required element marks 5.4 up to 5.8.
5.7.
And the best that we have seen so far. And now the second set of marks for presentation again. The highest that we have seen. 5.6 up to 5.8. The range for Michael Weiss, one of the key contenders here in Philadelphia this year.
That overall character, really quiet. Good.
Four-time U.S. champion Todd Eldridge believes that things happen for a reason. A dislocated shoulder earlier this season slowed his progress this year, but his target is still 4 weeks away.
Well, I think I'm right where I want to be at this point. I started the season off kind of indifferent, I guess you could say. And then since La Ligue, things have been going well, and you know, the Champions Series final went really well for me as far as my skating was concerned. So I think I started to build a little momentum there, and we'll just kind of keep it going, and hopefully at the end of February that'll be the peak of our momentum.
He is skating to walk on the wild side from the casino side track. He represents the DeJoyce Skating Club in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan. Ladies and gentlemen, Todd Eldridge.
Well, after watching Todd Eldridge throughout his career, you have to believe at this point he knows how to get ready for any competition and knows when to peak. Up and down career, but a champion.
This guy is a great competitor, but he still knows that Michael Weiss hit everything right before him. He knows that, and everybody wants this guy's position. They want to be the champion, so this is a tough place to skate.
On the Wild Side, from the movie Casino. His first move, a triple axel, two-jump combination. Triple axel, triple toe loop. Now that was superb.
That is probably one of Todd's most confident elements in this program.
And look at the centering he gets on this spin. Now, very few of the men or anybody in skating really gets good centers. He's one of them. That's really terrific spinning.
You know, that's what makes this program so great. It's a great package. Great spinning, great jumping. He looks okay. He looks wonderful with the choreography. It's good.
Footwork into his triple Lutz jump.
He's had trouble with that jump in all the practices, and I think that he'll be happy with that.
Kind of a microcosm of his career, though, fighting to hang on to it at the end.
Now look at this combination spin. First the camel. This spin, again, look at the centering that he gets there. That means spinning in one spot. Cannonball position, and look at this for a back spin. Now that's a good back spin.
Nobody does it better.
Nope. One more jump, this double axel. Remember when he blew the double axel after doing all the triple jumps? Lost concentration.
Beautiful.
Not this time. Well, there it was. Good for him. As steady as they come.
There's John and Ruth Eldridge, his mom, dad, his uncle is there as well. The folks in South Chatham, Massachusetts have been a big part of all of his accomplishments through the years. The entire town.
It's nice to see the whole families of all these skaters coming to the fore here and supporting them.
And what a sense of accomplishment skating after the great performance of Michael Weiss. He's got to feel great.
And this is a guy who almost gave up skating altogether back in the early 90s, but going after his fifth U.S. title would be one more than Scott Hamilton and Brian Boitano. Dick Button off in the stratosphere somewhere with seven.
Now, look at this triple axel. Watch him just take up straight, tight legs, beautiful turns, beautiful landing, stepping up right into a triple toe loop. You can't do better or more, be more secure than that is.
Now, here's his triple Lutz. Well, I want to see on the landing if he two-foots this. It looked like, to me, like he might have two-footed. He's a little setting up. Oh, no, he didn't. He did not two-foot it. He was a little far forward on the landing, but there's no deduction on that.
There's Richard Callahan, who also coaches Tara Lipinski, of course.
5.8.
Michael White with the highest scores yet, but here are the required element marks. All 5.8.
5.8.
The best so far.
5.8. And
well, after he won the competition in which he separated his shoulder, he came in fourth and third at the other major competitions this year. Really disappointed with those, but as you heard him say, he feels like he's in top shape right now. And the presentation marks 5.8 and 5.9 for Todd Eldridge. Perhaps on his way to his fifth national title. In the lead right now. We'll be back. Rivas defeated Brian Boitano to win his second consecutive national title, the biggest win of his career. He went on to finish eighth at the Olympics, and his future looked unlimited. But Davis was unable to maintain that level of success. Now he pursues a return trip to the Olympics, older and wiser.
Well, I think I've grown as a skater and grown up as a person. You know, like I said before, it kind of happened really fast for me, those 2 years, 93 and 94. And I didn't really know what went along with being national champion and being number one. So it kind of distracted me for a while. But now, you know, I've seen both sides of the coin and know more who I am and how to handle myself and the nerves and that aspect much better.
Handling nerves and meeting expectations, a big part of what Scott Davis has tried to tackle the last few years. When he finished second recently at a major competition, he said it was the best performance since his win at the Nationals in 94.
Jersey, Buddy Guy and Benny Goodman. And this is two-jump combination first, the triple axle. Triple loop, double loop. Very nice.
Really well done.
Why he puts it way up there in the corner of the rink, I'll never know. But I guess almost all the skaters move everything right to the edge of the barrier. Straight line into a triple lutz. Here it is. Ah, and he pops that. No. Well, I'll tell you something. That does a number on his part.
The four-tenths deduction right there.
But look at what a good spinner he is. He spins like a top. He and Todd Eldridge are wonderful spinners. They have great centers. Look at the speed he gets here. Flying death drop. One of the things he has going for him is he's very musical. Serpentine footwork. Look at the pattern that he's skating on the ice. These are good steps. Combination spin, first the camel, good speed, good center, wonderful speed, and a great back cross position.
You know, he's just got to be disappointed. He hit the hard thing, and he hit something that should be relatively easy for him to do.
But that's always what happens. It even happened with Todd Eldridge at the World Championship last year when he lost on the double axel at the end of the program.
Two spots available on the U.S. Olympic team. Todd Eldridge will get one of them. Michael Weiss, maybe, or Scott Davis, the other. We'll be back with his mark. Scott Davis came in very confident, but this is an unforgiving sport, isn't it?
To get great height on this triple lutz, you need to reach this right leg far back. He doesn't reach back quite enough, and he ends up popping it into a single.
And the clear reaction of his coach, Galina Zmijevskaya, is a beauty. Oh, look at that. How discouraging.
And Nina Petrenko, the wife of Victor Petrenko. Galina, her mother. Scott Davis, when he came in, he was coming off a second-place finish at the NHK competition, and he said it may have been his best performance that he can remember.
But even in that championship, he did not skate well in the short program. He had to pull himself up from fifth place.
Required element marks 4.9 to 5.4, the range, Dick. That's a wide range.
Yes, and the range is pretty high. You know, I mean, the level is pretty high for that major miss. But he'll get good marks here.
5.6.
Here you see the reflection of the 4.10 deduction. 5.2, 5.6 for the first set.
The presentation marks are higher. 5.5 up to 5.8. Scott Davis, that puts him in third place, right behind Michael Weiss.
And knocking out Shepard Clark.
Finish first and still finish up well. Well, no surprise, Todd Eldridge in the lead, but that second Olympic spot up for grabs. Michael Weiss and Scott Davis in great shape, Shepard Clark as well, and a gutsy performance by an injured Timothy Gabel. Leslie Visser is standing by with the two men on top of the leaderboard right now. Leslie?
Terry, these are two men who are halfway home. Todd, first to you. You got a standing ovation for your short program. What went well for you tonight?
Everything went pretty well. I went out. I felt really good. The ice felt good. And, good to get a good clean short under my belt and, hopefully have a good long.
Todd, you have to know that in the Olympics, at least three of your competitors will be attempting a quad. Why don't you do one here and get one under your belt?
Well, that's actually a decision that's still out. So, you know, most likely we probably won't, but, you know, we still haven't decided yet.
Well, we will wait and see. Congratulations so far. Michael, to you, our defending silver medalist, what did you want to showcase tonight?
Basically, I just wanted to get off to a good start, you know, come in, skate a clean short program, and get a good feeling for the ice and the audience and the crowd, and things went well for me tonight.
Well, now, you remember a year ago, you thought you landed a quad. Many people thought you landed a quad. How do you feel about this year, and what kind of quad will you attempt?
I feel great. You know, after Worlds last year, I really felt like the quad lutz was something that I wanted to go after. It was a more difficult quad, and it's something that nobody else in the world has landed. So it was something that I really wanted to personally go after myself, and I've really worked hard all this year, and it's going to be in the program for the long program.
Well, America will be watching. Congratulations so far to both of you. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Leslie, and you have to be happy for Scott Davis, the two-time U.S. champion. He indeed may be back. Michael Weiss could be on his way to the Olympics. He has the quad jump planned for the finals. And Todd Eldridge going after his fifth U.S. title. The finals on ABC tomorrow night, the men's free.